Welcome to the Daily Reminder Network. Heart Softeners by Sheikh Mu'izz Bukhari.
My dear respected elders, brothers and sisters, and the viewers of the Daily Reminder Network, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وأصلي وأسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا وحبيبنا وقرة أعيننا محمد بن عبد الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم أما بعد. All praise and thanks be to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is our creator, sustainer, nourisher, protector, and curer. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower His choicest of blessings and salutations upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family members, his companions, and all those who tread upon his path with utmost sincerity until the day of Qiyamah. Insha'Allah ta'ala, for tonight's heart softener, we will be touching on tarbiyatul awlad, and that is the proper upbringing of children. Because in general, many a time we touch on birrul walidain, where we touch on the rights of the children towards their parents. But it is also of utmost importance to touch on the rights of the parents towards their children, because after all, our children are great responsibilities that have been entrusted to us by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And most certainly we will be questioned about those great responsibilities that have been entrusted to us by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So inshallah ta'ala, we will be touching on a few responsibilities in terms of our children. Starting off, number one, with niyyah. Niyyah is of utmost importance when it comes to our children. Look at the story of the mother of Maryam alayha salatu wasalam. Scholars state her name was Hannah. She, during her pregnancy, she kept a very firm and beautiful intention in regard to her child. Because she was praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, she was wishing for a baby boy, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions what she stated. قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي نَذَرْتُ لَكَ مَا فِي بَطْنِي مُحَرَّرًا فَتَقَبَّلْ مِنِّي إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. She states, Ya Allah, إِنِّي نَذَرْتُ لَكَ مَا فِي بَطْنِي, that I wish to dedicate or vow what is in my womb for your service. فَتَقَبَّلْ مِنِّي, so accept from me. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ, you are all hearing and all knowing. Allahu Akbar. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's plan was different. But yet, because of her noble intention, because of that beautiful intention of hers, you know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought about? She gives birth to a daughter, and she's surprised, she's astonished as to what she's going to do with the daughter. But nevertheless, she fulfills her intention, her vow, and she dedicates her daughter to the service of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah the Almighty brings about Jesus, Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, through Maryam alayha salatu wasalam, a great prophet, Allahu Akbar, because of the intention, my dear brothers in Islam, because of that beautiful and noble intention, Allahu Akbar. So it is upon us parents to intend very beautifully in regard to our children. Let us have high ambitions for our children, because only if we do that will Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring about those intentions very beautifully. And at times perhaps it may not manifest in your child, it may manifest down the line, perhaps a generation or two down the line. So it is of utmost importance to keep good and high, noble intentions. Responsibility number two is to keep a beautiful name, is to name your child a very beautiful name. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said along the lines of these words, that the most beloved or the most beautiful of names unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Abdullah and Abdul Rahman. Allahu Akbar. Abdullah and Abdul Rahman. Hadith is in Bukhari, if I'm not mistaken. Nevertheless, it is upon us to name our children beautiful names that have good meanings, because Whenever a parent calls out to his or her child, it is actually almost a dua. Almost a dua. Say, for example, you call out your child Salih. Say, if you name your child Salih and you call out Salih, Salih means a pious and a righteous person. So just in case at that moment when you're calling out, if it coincides and a malak, an angel says Ameen, it becomes a dua. Allahu Akbar. And that is why at times you have to be careful when you name your children at times with names along the lines like, for example, Aqil. Aqil, when you pronounce it properly with the Ayn and the Qaf, Ayn, Alif, Qaf and Lam. Aqil, then there is no problem, because then the translation is a very intelligent person, a person with sound intellect. But on the other hand, if you pronounce that name as Aqil, which happens generally because it becomes easy, Aqil, Aqil, you call a person. Now you know what the meaning of Aqil is with a Hamza and a Kaf? A person who eats a lot. Otherwise, a glutton, you know, who eats a lot, a greedy person, you say Aqil. So now you wouldn't want your child to become a person who eats a lot when you call it Aqil. Aqil is a person who eats. So we have to be very careful when we name our children. It is good if you can refer to a scholar, perhaps to the Ahlul Ilm, in terms of naming your children. A name with a good meaning, which would also become a dua for that child. Allahu Akbar. Because many a time, there was once an instance when a person, if I'm not mistaken, a person comes to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and his name was Hazan, if I'm not, or Huzan, which means grief, worry, distress. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him to change his name to Sahel. Sahel means ease, facilitation. Because when you call out the name, that actually manifests, that quality manifests itself in the child. And at times it becomes a dua. So responsibility number two is naming your child with a beautiful name. Now, responsibility number three is to treat your children with fairness. To treat your children fairly. Allahu Akbar. And this is something very sad, because today we see many parents, we do not treat our children with fairness. We do not treat our children fairly. At times, even when gifting things to our children, whether it be from the estate, whether it be from wealth, whether it be houses, anything, whatever it may be, we have to treat all of our children equity, with equity and fairness. Every single thing that we do with our children should be with fairness. There should be no favoration in between the children. But of course, after the death of a father or a mother, the inheritance will go according to the laws of Sharia. But during the lifetime of the parents, we should treat our children with utmost justice and utmost fairness. This is extremely important, because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is reported to have said, fear Allah and treat your children fairly. Allahu Akbar. Fear Allah and treat your children fairly. So it is upon us to treat our children with fairness. The next in line is to treat our children with love and mercy. Allahu Akbar. If you look at the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the greatest prophet ever, the seal of the prophets, he was a leader for the people. He was an army commander. He had so much of responsibilities upon his shoulders, but yet he used to treat children with beautiful love and mercy. There are so many incidents in the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Take for instance, one day Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the imam. In general, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam conducts the salah. So he was the imam, and the sahaba ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhi majma'in were praying behind him. And in the final sujood, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam lengthened the sujood so much to the extent that the sahaba became worried, because all of them were in sajda. They can't see what's happening. They were wondering, why is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam lengthening the sajda? They thought perhaps wahi is descending on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They were perturbed and they were worried. So after a while, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam gets up and finishes the salah. The sahaba ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhi majma'in then ask, Ya Rasulullah, what was the reason behind you lengthening the sajda so long? Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam explains, it wasn't wahi, because they ask him, did any wahi come down? It wasn't wahi, but rather it was my grandson Hussein radiyallahu an who climbed over my back, Allahu Akbar, whilst I was in sujood, and I did not want to interrupt interrupt his happiness. He was frolicking and playing over my back. So I waited in sajda until he finished and got down from my back. And then I finished the salah. Allahu Akbar. The leader, Allahu Akbar, the imam. He did not just push the child over. No. He treated the child with so much of love and care, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. Another instance. Same situation. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam lengthens the sajda. And then afterwards, the sahaba radhiyallahu ta'ala alayhim ajma'in see Hassan and Hussein radhiyallahu anhuma, both were frolicking and playing by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they understood the reason must be because one of them must have climbed on the back of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So after salah, Abu Huraira radhiyallahu anhu comes to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he asks, Ya Rasulullah, shall I take them and drop them by their mother? Fatima radiallahu anha, shall I take them home? Because it was night. It was night and it was extremely dark. At the times of Sahaba Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhi majma'in, you did not have all these street lights and etc. So it was extremely dark. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam instructed Abu Huraira radiallahu an, Ya Abu Huraira, no, let them be. And he carried one of them, Hassan radiallahu anhu, and places him on one side of his lap, Hussein radiallahu an, and on the other side of the lap, and he was playing with them. Suddenly there was a flash of lightning, Allahu Akbar. There was a flash of lightning that filled the whole of Medina with light, Allahu Akbar. And the light did not cease, it remained, it was standstill. It was like a flash and it remained. The whole of Medina was illuminated, Allahu Akbar. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then instructed Hassan and Hussein radiallahu an, you all may now go home, go to your mother, go quickly to your mother. And then they run. Because everything was illuminated, Allahu Akbar. They found their way home very easily. It was a miracle bestowed upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another instance, there was a sahabiyya radiallahu anha by the name Ummu Qais ibn Mihsan. She comes to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with a suckling child, a baby child, and she gives the child to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam carries the child, and whilst he was playing with the child urinates on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The minute he sees that the child urinated on him, he starts to smile, Allahu Akbar. The leader of the faithful, Allahu Akbar, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. He was a mercy to both worlds, Allahu Akbar. He was a mercy indeed. He asks for some water and he washes the urine away, Allahu Akbar. Another instance, he was on the pulpit, he was conducting the Jum'ah sermon. He was conducting the sermon at that time. And then suddenly in the middle of the sermon, he gets down and he goes to two children. Who are they? Hassan and Hussein radiallahu anhu. Just walking like this youngster. They were walking around. He goes, he carries. He stops in the middle of the khutbah. Allahu Akbar. Middle of the khutbah. Today, I doubt any imam would do that. You know, things are so serious and people are disturbed when the child comes to the first row. They chase the child away. This is not from the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is not how we should treat our children, Allahu Akbar. He carries both of them, climbs back onto the minbar and continues the sermon and he recites the ayah. Innama amwalukum wa awladukum fitnah. That indeed your children and your wealth are a fitna to you. In other words, a trial, a test. You are tested with your wealth and your children because of that love that you have for your children. Allahu Akbar. This is how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to treat children, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. It is upon us to treat our children with utmost love and mercy. They need our time. We should not shun them away. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make time for children, give salams to them, talk to them, pat them on their heads and all of those things. But today, if you look at a leader of the community, you can't even reach out to him, let alone him coming and patting and talking to the child. Allahu Akbar. Because those children, they are the future of our society. We need to treat them with love and care. Allahu Akbar. The next two responsibilities, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, let me run through them swiftly. The next is to make dua for them. As we all know, a parent's dua is accepted in regard to the children, Allahu Akbar, in regard to his or her children. It is upon us to make good dua. However angry we are, let us not scold our children using bad names such as, you know, derogatory terms. You know, let's not scold them because at times it can become a curse. You know, just as how when you call them a good name, it can be a dua. When you call them something bad, it can become a curse, and that might result in foolishness being sealed off for the child. If you call him a fool or call him an idiot, Allahu Akbar. Let us call them with good names and let us make good dua for them. And finally, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, let us establish a good environment for our children, Allahu Akbar, at home, where good knowledge in regard to Iman, in regard to Allah, in regard to the life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, in regard to the life of the Sahaba Ridwan Allah Ta'ala alayhi majma'in, is taught to our children. We need to show our children good role models. And remember, in general, you are the superman to your child. You are the superman to your child. Your child looks up to you. If you are not righteous, if you are not pious, don't expect your child to become a saint. Don't expect. Some parents want their children to become saints. While they are not pious, they are not righteous. We need to first change, and then our children will automatically change because they see it in their parents. Allahu Akbar. Finally, I leave you with this hadith, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said that upon death of an individual, all of his good deeds cease. All of his good deeds stop except for three. Number one, a sadaqah jariya, a charity that has, for example, you build a masjid, say for example, and people pray in that masjid, the reward will keep coming. An ongoing charity, sadaqah jariya. And under that, and that is one of the reasons why we encourage people to try and give charity to the masajid perhaps and madrasas, etc., so that it becomes an ongoing charity. Number two is the imparting of knowledge. Because the more, say, you leave behind knowledge, say in the form of books or your teachings, if people benefit from them, even after your death, you get your reward. And that is one of the reasons why we put so much of emphasis in regard to videos of this nature. Because say, down the line, you see, these videos are up on YouTube. Down the line, maybe after a year or two, maybe even after my death, Allahu Akbar, people may watch this. One person may watch one video and be inspired by that, Allahu Akbar. The reward will keep coming to the person who imparted the knowledge, Allahu Akbar. And finally, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, a righteous child. You leave behind a righteous child, a child who prays for his parents, the reward keeps coming to those parents, Allahu Akbar. So let us work on our children. Let us bring them up properly. Let us make proper tarbiyah of our children. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of our sins. May He accept our good deeds. May He help us to upbring our children properly, Allahu Akbar. Let Him help us to nurture our children properly. And may He accept all of our good deeds. May He unite us in the gardens of Jannah, just as how He united us here tonight with our beloved Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa akhir da'waya an alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Jazakum Allahu khair.
Donate now. Go to www.thedailyreminder.org/donate. And stay updated by joining our network's social links.